This is Gary Stewart's fault. He asks me to sing it every year, so this is the time it's got to get done this year. The song's called Baltic Street, and there's a poem by Violet Jacob for the Deep South. Well, not the Deep South, no, she just sooth of it. Dunan Angus. Is anybody in Fianna Angus today? I kind of thought there might be. So Baltic Street, and Carole got interested in the poems of Violet Jacob through the wonderful Jim Reid, and she got hold of this poem that she particularly liked and put a tune to it and sung it as Baltic Street, the song. And very shortly after that, I stole it. Sorry, no, folk a day in these days, you can't steal things, you collect them from. So I collected this one from my deep down in my cat. What a big
suitcase.
My dainty lass, lay ye the blame upon the recruit. 'Twas daft ill luck that begged your name, the wrang side o' tweed. Ye have took a rock and bleed. Your bonny as a rose, but I was born in Baltic Street.
In Baltic Street,
Montrose. Lang syne on Murray's away for next, I ever sees this dress. I've seen the great ends o' the left, swinging at face of the ness, and put in summer sunny blinks, when land winds raise and fail, I'd flee my dragon on the links, wake Alan's like myself. But Baltic Street is cold and bare, and the day no say grand, but you'll feel the smell in the colour air. Oh, Kappar's on the land, twixt Kirk and Street, the deed folk bide. The feet towards the sea, I'll never far a new made bride. Can you come here with me? The steeple shades the kirkyard grass, the seaman's hidden beams, a door like kirk. An English lass, wha kens but English lanes, and when the half the winter through creeps blind and close and wall, my hamach gets a curse for you. Sell get my so up and off the morn's morn to seek some retired coin, bold hearted, strong, neat bread and born in the salt to.
Baltic Street, in Baltic Street.
something around and leave it to Carole's tender version. Good luck.
Okay. It's very nice, isn't it?
Of course I'm nice.
In the year 1755, Dr. Samuel Johnston wrote his Dictionary of the English Language, and in it he described the word oats as a grain which in England is fed to horses, but in Scotland supports the people.
Hey!
Samuel Johnson wasn't too fond of Scottish vernacular languages. In fact, he wanted to standardise them all, so big thumbs down. But I quite like the idea of Scotland being a nation that was built on oats, because it served us very well across the centuries. So this is my wee song, which is an observation on Scots cuisine, past and present, with special reference to oats, which comes in as a random chorus here and there.
So what's the chorus?
Oats.
We'll never remember that.
What springs to mind of Scotland's fairin' is the lads that raised up on tatties and herring, or Coulter's candy that's fed to bairns? Or is it just a nation that was built on oats? We've always had the finest produce, big broad berries, brimfuo juice, loupin salmon and heelin coos, from the nation that was built on oats. Lang, lang ago, ooh, bonny fechters, Bruce and Wallace, the land's protectors, faced Albion, twa local spectres, Wilford laddies that were built on oats. And over time, our country's dying, with the alley blues in the old alliance, dishes new come into parlance in the nation that was built on oats. Dollops of collops, a big cow toady served up in ashes, and feathered fowly, he'll float out and a doddo crowdy, graced the nation that was built on oats. Mere recent times, a mixter maxter brought cooking wifeys like Ina Baxter, tried to preserve a good Scots larder, many recipes included oats. But yin or yang prevails today, through heaven or hell, as some might say, mostly depends what you can pay. In the nation that was built on oats, nouvelle cuisine, far folk that's poorer, deep fried marsh bars in the butter tempura, pies on rolls are quickly hoovered, not to mention the pizza crunch. When you're out dining with your buddies, dinna be seek doing your best studies. Perchance your stew has been made frae caddies. Just be honest, call it steak cheval. New copious chefing, cognoscenti, serve single leaves on dishes dainty. Michelin stars abound in plenty in the nation that was built on oats. And mind ye dinny brack your molars on crustacean critters and bottom crawlers, like razor clams, prey electrified trawlers. What day go diving in the Firth of Forth? Even the haggis, your culinary symbol, comes in pecoras, and as a timble, with matching wines, served out in thimbles. Welcome to Embro, you have had your tea. At every menu, you tack a gander, the soups I carrot and coriander, all that stay hell in a smoothie blender. ni lumpy broth new in the land of boats. Across the years, as one peruses, here's to our grains of money, you says. John Barleycorn inspires our muses in the nation that was built on oats. So bless our groves and bless your bannocks, oats at road and your cabbocks. It's even nice, fried up with haddocks. May your pulses never fail. And in the end, now here's the question, answers on a postcard. Welcome suggestion. Have I left a smile or just indigestion in the nation that was built on oats? So raise your glasses. Here's the toast to this fair land we love the most. From Maiden Kirk to John O'Groats, a hail to the nation that was built on oats.
Right, we'll leave you to go on the rest of the concert tonight with this one. Carol usually introduces this one because she's absolutely brilliant on geography and angles and distances and all that. It's called Broom of the Cowden Now is a song. Cowden Now is a wee place down the borders, and she usually says that I think it's 35 miles southeast of Edinburgh. I didn't care if we got the measuring tape out, but that's what it supposedly is. And it's just a good wee sing-alongy song. You'll probably all ken it. And if you didn't ken it now, you will by the end of it. A few chorusy bits. And Cowden Now is a place down the borders near a place called Sorrowless Field, which is a wee farm not a million miles away. And it is the only farm on the borders where, after the Battle of Flodden, all of the men folk came back to the farm, which there wasn't any, that was not the case in most of the farms and the farm towns and the towns and villages round the borders there, because we lost an awful lot. We nearly won the night, didn't we? Oh, not quite, but anyway, Broom of the Cowden Now. You hear the guitar?
Yeah.
Good. Just me that can't hear it.
How blithe was I a morning to see, must wake a yeah.